Hi, I'm Brian with KISSmetrics, and I'm here to help you get the most out of your Google Analytics account. Today, we're talking about segmentation. I'm going to show you a super simple way to use segmentation to find out everything you ever wanted to know about the traffic coming to your website. You'll be able to know how old they are, what gender they are, whether they're new visitors or old visitors, and a ton of other stuff. And I'm going to show you how to use pretty little colors on your Google Analytics dashboard to see all of that in seconds. So let's get going. So what are segments? Think about it this way. When someone comes to your website, Google Analytics is able to find out quite a bit of information about that individual. By contrast, when you log into your Google Analytics account, the very first thing you see is that graph of the last month that shows you everybody that's been there, and it's up and down, hopefully more up than down, but it shows you the total number of visitors, total number of unique visitors. All that does is show you a 50,000 foot view of your website. It doesn't break that down. What segments allow you to do is to group people with similar characteristics together and see their numbers on that graph. For instance, you could see every female that's come to your website and see how many females have been there, how many males have been there, people from a specific location. You can see of that traffic that's come to your website in the last month, how much of that has been new visitors, how much of that has been return visitors. You can see all that information and make it actionable for your website. That's what segments are. Simply put, segmentation allows you to easily group visitors to your website by similar characteristics. Now, how do you use them? To access segmentation, it's simple. Once you've selected your profile from the admin page, just click the drop-down arrow next to the default All Visits view. This will toggle the advanced segmentation screen. There are quite a few built-in segments that you can set up with just one click. In this example, we're going to add returning users and a new visitor segment. To do this, we'll simply click those items and they'll be added to the dashboard. Now click Apply and you're all done. You can see now at the top, next to All Visits, the new segments have been added. Your main traffic graph is now color-coded to show each segmentation separated out. You can also scroll down into the Details section to see individual statistics and graphs on each separate segmentation. To remove a segmentation, just click the X in the upper right-hand corner and it'll be removed. So the big question now is, how do you use segmentation to grow your business? There are literally thousands of ways to do that, and it completely depends on your business and the intricacies of it. Let me share with you one example of how I use segmentation just in the last 2 weeks to grow my business. I've been using a couple new outreach techniques to grow a new blog that I set up 3 months ago. And over the course of those 3 months, a large majority of my traffic has been from new visitors. I've averaged over 100 new visitors per blog post. But just in the last 2 weeks, I've noticed a dip in that. It's gone to less than 50 new visitors per blog post. The percentages are even more out of whack. Luckily, I had my default graph when I log into Google Analytics set up to show all visits as well as new and returning visitors. That showed me this graph intersect and my return visitors pass my new visitors. And that alerted me to there's something going on. Why do I not have the same number of new visitors, at least the same number, if not the same percentage of numbers per total viewers as I have in the past? And that let me dig into my processes, and I realized, hey, I'm not doing an intricate part of the process that I had been doing in the past. What I had left out was sending a follow-up email to the people that I targeted in my blog post. In every blog post, I'll interview somebody or do a case study on a particular person. And right before that blog post goes out, for the first 2 months, I'd been emailing that person hours before to let them know, hey, this blog post is about to go live. But I'd forgot to do that over the last 2 weeks. I hadn't sent that one email, and it made a difference of over 50% in the new visitors to my website. Because what would happen when I sent that email, that person would tweet it out, would share it, would send in a newsletter, and drive traffic from their audience back to me. So having this set up, having advanced segmentation set up in my dashboard, has saved me from losing tons of new readers. You can get a lot more ideas on how you can use customer segments to improve your business by visiting the Google Analytics Customer Solutions Gallery. To view it, just click the drop-down arrow like before, then choose Import from Gallery. This allows you to use one of the many already configured segments. They all include descriptions to tell you exactly what they do, and you can see if it'd be a good fit for your site. Another option is you can also set up custom segments. Just navigate back to the segment pop-up like before and choose Create New Segment. This will allow you to create completely custom tailored segments. I recommend using this only if there's no defaults and if there's nothing in the Google Gallery that fits your specific configuration. So that is segmentation. One awesome thing about segmentation is it's retroactive. So if you've never used segmentation before, you can enable it now and view all the historic data about all the visitors that have ever come to your website since you've installed Google Analytics. So you can look back into the past and get insight in what to do in the future by using segmentation. So that's it, now your part. I want you to share with me, if you've used segmentation in the past, a segment that you've used that has shown you insight into your company, and tell us how you used it and what the results were. So that's it for this week. Until next time, happy analytics.